Hello, I'm Colin Harris. I'm the Chief Operating Officer of PMC Sierra. And first of all, I'd just like to thank all of you for listening to me. It's a privilege to get to talk to such a great crew of people about technology. I'm going to jump right into it. Remember a few years ago, there was a lot of talk about how Moore's Law was ending. You know, the benefits of scaling would not have any advantage. And normally when we have a technology node jump, we expect to see the power go down, the cost go down, and the performance go up. Going from 28 to 16 nanometer, it looked like those benefits weren't going to happen. There was, you know, although the chips got smaller, their cost didn't go down. The cost per gate or cost per function stayed the same. So, and there's all these restrictive design rules at 16 nanometers, so the cost to develop is more. So why do all this work and end up with a chip that frankly costs about the same amount of money? Yet we see a lot of people going from 20 to 8 to 16, and in matter of fact, 16 is a widely adopted node in this day and age. So what happened? Were all the chip guys like me, are we all dumb, or is something different happened? And I think it's explainable. We're not dumb. One of the biggest challenges in 28 and 40 nanometer was controlling power. That caused a lot of development cost and a lot of hard work. With 16 nanometer in the FinFET, we get a big power jump down for free. So with the same design effort, we get much lower power. So I think that explains why, you know, the conversation about Moore's Law kind of got pushed aside for a little while because of this low power benefit from 16 nanometer. Looking forward, as we go on to deeper nodes, we're going to need some innovation because we can't just scale and not get cost benefits. So that's my spiel, that's my thought, and we need some innovation to make the next nodes more competitive.